How's it going, crew? This is Happy Days, and welcome back to our Helena the Huntress Expert Mode Let's Play. So have you all had an awesome Christmas spending time with friends and family, got lots of cool presents, and are ready for the new year? It's pretty exciting stuff, guys. So in this episode, we have a lot to do. I'd like to make a few adjustments to our arena, which is pretty much just adding a little volcano trap to the bottom, because we're going to do a few quick farming montages to get a few more banners, which will be awesome. And I think the wizard might have died in the last pirate invasion. We also scattered out the jungle last episode, which means we now know where we're going to make our arena to fight Plantera, so that's going to be pretty cool too. We might get some more life crystals, which will be nice, life fruit rather. And we could start exploring the lizard temple as well. So we have heaps of stuff to do, guys. Let's get started. Okay, so let's start this by upgrading our arena. And all it's going to take is... ooh, I can make crystal blocks. Awesome. They look really cool. Alright, all it's going to take is a couple of snow bricks and just a bit of lava. And what we're going to do is make an actual little lava trap that the mobs will fall into. Is that a golden bunny? No way! That's huge! Yes, bunny, come to me. Oh, don't kill it. Yeah, golden bunny! Oh, yeah! Oh, so awesome. Bunny, we're going to make a throne for you. Oh my gosh, I've already got one bunny. Oh, the queen is here. The bunny queen. Alright, I'm getting a bit distracted. So all we need to do to our arena is we're just going to perhaps remove this platform here. We're going to make a small volcano. And what will happen is the spider will damage the enemy, so we'll still get the banner kills. Now this is just to speed up the collection of some of the banners, like the pirate ones, where, yeah, it's a bit grindy. And even though, yeah, I could just hang around and fight them for hours on end, I'm sure you guys would rather watch me do more interesting things. So we'll make a nice little banner here. Not a banner, just fix up the platforms, because we're going to be hanging lots of banners off that in the future. And what we'll do here, I'm just thinking, how are we going to approach this? So basically, all we need is... oh, puppy. Why are you so silly? Alright, we're just going to raise the sides a bit. So the pirates fall in and then they can't get out. And then, yeah, we just pretty much make a nice design like this. And the poor pirates run up the side and then get trapped and then get destroyed. Which is all very nice. Alright, and what we can actually do too is make... oh, I could use teleporters. Yeah, why don't I use teleporters? Because we've got the steampunker. Where is she? I think she might have moved into the truffles house, which is a little bit annoying. Let's see. There you are. Good old Whitney. This is for the truffle. No. Oh. All right. So let's get two teleporters. Oh, contaminator. Awesome. That's so good. Okay. So we've got wiring, got teleporters. We also need... oh, I love Rod of Discord. Where's the mechanic? Oh, I always forget where she is. Mechanic, where are you? There she is. Beautiful. Alright, we need... oh my gosh, I always forget which is which. I think blue is for people. blue is for people. Actually, I think I might use switches instead, because they're a bit cleaner than, doing other stuff. Alright, so let's put... the first teleporter, let's put it in the ground so it doesn't block mobs. Ah! What happened? oh, Cthulhu Dash, you're so crazy. All right, let's put the first one in the ground here, and then we can just wire it through to underneath, which will be really nice. We'll be right back. here we are in the dungeon for the next part of our mission. I realized on our first run through, we never picked up a bewitching table, which is kind of crazy. I think I got two alchemy tables, but only zero bewitching tables, which is a bit sad because, oh my god, 950 angry bones. Ah, so crazy. Yeah, we never ended up getting one, so that's okay because we can get one now. Now, if you remember, ooh, a Valor, cool, meteorite bars, yeah, we'll take those. The reason I don't like restoration potions is it triggers both potion and health debuffs at the same time, so meh. Okay, yeah, so when we fought the Wall of Flesh, I was talking to a lot of you and you said that it'd be cool if Helena could power up to summon two minions in hard mode, but that's an alchemy station, isn't it? I'm like, oh my god, did I have one all along? Alright, let's swap that with a bewitching table. Yeah, that's cool. And I agreed with a lot of you and said that we can summon two, but they have to be different. And that way we're more like a hunter and not just like a summoner that can just spam everything. Alright, so we've got a slime staff, I think would be a nice companion. So slimy and spider, very nice, the two of them together. I think I've got some blue paint somewhere, although the colours of that kind of work with it. So what I'd like to do now is actually try out our new mob farm here with some pirates. So we got our maps. What I'll do is I'll clean my inventory a bit and then we'll give it a shot, guys. Okay, here they come. The pirates are on their way. And I remember that Slimy has a bad habit of jumping out of the mob box, but we should be okay, and I put little lips on the sides of the volcano so the summons can't jump outside of the box, which is going to help a fair bit, I think. So as you can see, this is churning through them nicely, and I've put the banners down here so we can see where we're up to. Spider, have you jumped in the box with me? Oh, no way. Yeah, I've got Bewitched on. Okay, have we got Spider? Yeah, we got Spider. Alright, so this should be a nice way to churn through a bit of loot here. So I'll speed this up and we'll see how we go. Oh wow, we ground a lot of pirates, and we got lots of nice furniture, which is cool too. And I have a feeling, whoops, I swapped my Discord out. I have a feeling, oh yes, there is. A Flying Dutchman has spawned up here. And we are much better equipped to deal with this now, that it's a bit later in the game. Oh, look at that, guys. So nice. We can actually just destroy it nice and easily. So, we can actually just leave it there to farm pirates more or less endlessly. However, we do need to grind. I think the pirate captain has a banner, which is pretty rare. I think I've only killed like three of him so far. So, yeah, that's going to take a little while. So I might get some more loot boxes set up. Got a few pirate maps, so I might just chill out and grind a few of these away. And actually, if I can include like a little loot room in here, that would be really nice. Maybe if I can expand this out a bit. Piggy, you got my snow blocks? Beautiful. Yeah, if we could just expand this a bit to include some loot storage, that would be pretty nice. So I think I went, whoopsies. I think I went about three blocks that way. If we do the same that way, is that about the same? Yeah, that's cool. And then we can just put in like, I don't know, actually if I make it deeper, I might be able to have like two chests on each side. That might be a bit better again. Oh look, this is a big decision, guys, you know, keeping loot is very serious business. Alright, so I'll work out how I'm going to do the chests, and then I can just store all this awesome loot inside. Oh my gosh, so much fun. Well, this has been really fun, and I made it nice and neat, and... I may have disposed of Santa trying to get the truffle to spawn, but he's moved back into the truffle's house, so I might have to put up some temporary housing so the truffle will move in. Anyway, I did another pirate invasion, so we've got a nice amount of loot so far, and I put the extra cash in Piggy. And this is set up, we've got some more maps, and I can put other invasion loot in these boxes too, which is really cool. However, I think the time has come to make our way back to the jungle in preparation for a Plantera fight. We've got decent health, we've got nice weapons, we've got our titanium armor. I think it's time to go do this, guys. So, let's see. I'm going to need a couple of mining potions. Let's take a spelunker. And let's see. Archery, swiftness, regen. What else could we use? Iron skin's always good. And I feel like I'm missing one. What am I missing? Alright, regen, blah, archery, blah, 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 blah. No, I think I've got it all. That's all I'd usually use. Ooh, Titan potions will most likely be useful for Plantera's, like, creeper things. Oh, wow. I bought a gypsy robe off the traveling merchant. I was interested to see how it looked on Helena. I don't know, what do you guys think? I think the color's wrong, but I don't mind the outfit. So maybe if we can think of some good dyes to put on her, it might look good. Let's see. I don't know though. Hades dye. The flaming gypsy robe. Bright blue. That's a bit better. The living ocean looks a bit... it's kind of cool. Yeah, that's a bit better. Anyway, let me know guys if you can think... Do you like the look of the gypsy robe? What dye do you think we should wear? It's kind of cool. I don't mind it. I'm not 100% on it, but it's alright. It's a start. Okay, I'm going to make my way to the jungle, and let's start building our arena. Here we are in the jungle as I fend off the evil moss hornets that are really, really damaging in expert mode. It's really surprising. Like, I've got... I don't know, I can't quite see how much armor I've got. What's that? 47. I've got 47 armor, and yet they seem to do... I don't know, it feels like about 100 damage a hit. And because they attack so rapidly, and the projectiles are hard to see, you really can get into trouble very quickly against them. But anyway, this is the large area I commented on before that would make a good arena. So what we need to do is, which is actually going to be nice, actually block... Oh no, whoops. Is block it off a bit, which will thankfully reduce the spawn rate of all these hornets a bit and protect us from all the other random mobs too. So it's just a case of starting a... Like, I'm just using wood because it's something I've got plenty of. And just starting to block it off. I think I saw a tortoise. they're a two-hit kill, so they are really dangerous. Okay, so I've finished digging out the area, and I've made the roof nice and tall, because if we're going to be using the storm bow, we're going to need that extra room. Oh, hey, merchant. We're going to need that extra room to be able to shoot the storm bow nice and easily. So we don't want the shots getting blocked. Well, it's mostly yo-yo stuff you get from him, hey. Alright, that's cool. Alright, so, and then we've got the area down the bottom where the spiky balls can drop to. And we've got two little honey baths, which is nice. So that should give us enough maneuverability for the fight, I believe. So, I guess our next step is to look around and see if we can find a bulb. Alright, let's begin our exploration here. Nope, not pickaxe. We don't want pickaxe. Oh, it's this Medusa area. Oh, I don't want to get attacked by a crazy stone attack and die again. Alright, so there's not likely to be bulbs in the mushroom biome. So we can probably stay away from there relatively safely. Ooh, Arapaima, huh? Arapaima. I think I've already killed quite a few of those. Alright, so let's make our way along here. And in fact, let's put a Spelunker on. Because we might be able to get some life crystals too. Which would be really, really nice. And whoa! Giant tortoise! Ah, don't let it touch you! Crazy tortoise. Oh, Hoplites. Hey, guys. what's going on, Mr. Hoplites? Alright, let's take out these guys. Nope, don't shoot me, you crazy hornet! Oh my god, so much damage! Oh my god. Oh. Hey, oh no, I think I've checked out that ivy chest. Oh man, oh my god. Oh! What are you doing, my little friend? What are you doing here? Oh, hello, Mr. Bulb. Hello, you look so lonely. You look like you want to summon a crazy big boss. Okay, well, I think we might have to wait till our potion timer goes back down. So, how's about, let's get this chlorophyte quickly while we're waiting. Also, oh, man, we still haven't found, actually, ouch. I'm like half dead. I don't really want to start the fight half dead. I don't think that's a great idea. So, we'll wait for our timer to expire. But also, let's have a quick look around. We might be able to find a life crystal, a life fruit, sorry. Interchangeable, they sort of do the same thing, you know. It's just like, yeah. Okay, well, there's a life crystal. Careful what you wish for, huh, Happy? Oh, and there is a ton of chlorophyte. So let's just take a moment. I want my health to regenerate naturally. So let's see, let's get back up here. All right, yep, beautiful. Alright, so, yeah, I think we've got everything right. We probably could put our other mining potion in the pig. Yeah, that's good. Alright, so let's equip our holy arrows. Yep, lovely. And it's go time, guys. You ready? Oh, no. Here she comes. Where is she? So I'm using your trick. A lot of you said keep your mini map open. It'll show where she's coming from. And I like that. That's a good tip. All right, let's get our buffs on. Oh, and here comes the craziness. Now, the interesting thing with Plantera is just because we're using the storm bow doesn't mean it's going to be an easy fight. The problem with archers is they have lower armor. So keeping our health high during this fight is going to be important. In fact, just dodging damage in the first place is going to be important. Oh, you could even see a few of the arrows were getting blocked there. Not all of them, but a few when I come up to the top part. So that's a little bit scary. Oh, okay. So far, so good. We're doing okay. I wouldn't mind getting some honey. Yep, beautiful. Oh, and those spiky balls are just being kept out of the way. Hey, those little bullets have a homing thing on them. I didn't even realize they did. Wow, that's crazy. Oh, here it comes. Here comes the pain, guys. Oh, this is the scary part of the fight. We need to take out these creepers. Oh, or we're, like, doomed. Oh. If we can get rid of most of the creepers, we'll be okay. Ouch, they do so much damage. Oh my god, Stormberry, hit them! No! I bounced back off one! No! Oh, no. Okay, it looks like most of the spiky balls are almost gone. That is a positive in this world of pain. As I'm trying to fly through all the tentacles. Oh, okay. We've almost got all of them. Oh, yeah, we'll even get some honey. And that's the tricky part. When she first spawns all those creepers, you need some way to get rid of them. Like, oh. That was tricky with the yo-yo playthrough too. Just trying to get rid of them all. Oh my god. Okay. Oh, we're still not. How low is she? Come on, die! Oh, she's getting quicker. 4 seconds off a heal. No. I think Shadow Dodge just kicked in. Oh, we're so lucky. Oh my god. Oh my god. Die. Oh man. Oh yeah. Dungeon's been upgraded. Sweet. No, don't just spawn new mobs straight away. I don't appreciate. Oh wow, it's a nymph. We're up to, this will be our 8th nymph. Yeah! Oh, no way. See, we're almost there, guys. 8 nymphs. Oh, my God. Oh, wow, that was tough. That was actually genuinely tough. I found that difficult. Oh my god. Okay, I probably don't need jungle grass. That's not the one you can put in your hair. Nah, that's the jungle rose I'm thinking of. Okay, let's keep that. I've already got a few bat banners. We'll keep the metal detector. That's kind of fun. In fact, I probably could keep that in my inventory. Why not? And let's open some treasure, guys. Are you ready for treasure? In 3, 2, 1, Plantera! Oh, spore sack. Pygmies! Yeah, we can upgrade our summon. Actually, pygmy is probably going to be so much better than spider. Okay, guys, thanks as always for watching another episode of Helena the Huntress. Oh, it was a really fun episode. I really liked taking a bit of time to upgrade our farm and also taking on Plantera. And I think we got lucky in that fight. We could have easily died towards the end. I think the shadow dodge from our titanium armor may have saved us towards the end there. So very happy about that. But I'm also thinking I might try and get an upgraded bow next episode. The Daedalus Stormbow, whilst is very strong, is starting to lack a bit of punch versus the bosses because their armor gets so much higher. It'd be nice if we had something that deals direct damage. But we'll see about that next episode anyway. Alright, it's time for some shoutouts as always. And our first one is from T. Ludlow. And thus we say in a Han Solo voice. Oh gosh. And thus we say, Chewie, there's cookies. Oh, that wasn't a good Han. And I just saw the movie too. Oh no. Our next one is from Bam Bam Piper 1212. And they've asked me to say, in a wyvern voice, oh sweet, I got an invitation from Rufus. Will there be cookies? Oh, wyvern, it's a trap. Don't go, it's a trap, it's a trap. And next one is from Piggy Gaming, and they've asked me to say in a Rufus voice, hey Happy, why wasn't I in the Christmas special? Oh gosh, it's tough. I'd love to have everyone in there, but yeah, Rufus is one of our newer characters, so might have him in a reflection in the future. Alright, our next one is from Jill Matheson, and they've asked me to say, Happy, I've come for your cookies! And there might have been a meow in there, but I couldn't quite tell. So, meow cookies. And the last one is from Eno. I'm pretty sure that's how you say it. And I don't know if it was a shout-out directly, but they noted that in my Christmas video, I didn't remind everyone to eat lots of cookies over Christmas. So thanks for reminding me, Eno. So if you haven't already, and it's still, you know, you've still got family around, still got lots of food, make sure you eat lots of cookies. It's amazing. Alright guys, thanks so much for watching. Leave a like if you've enjoyed the video. If you're still watching now, click that like button, show your support for the series. Comments and suggestions are always welcome. And yeah, I always flick through the comments, even if I don't personally respond to you. Know that your comment has been read, and I always love feedback. I'm always acting on feedback to make our videos bigger and better all the time. And if you haven't subscribed, click the little HD icon in the bottom right corner, and you'll get our latest videos straight to your sub box, just like magic. Here's the most important part, as always. You will stay happy, and I'll see you soon. This is Happy Day signing out. See ya! Alright, now let's find out where this lava is. Mr. Lava! Oh goodness. Okay, we've got a heal off, nice. Oh, he's about to go in his last form. Oh, what are we- No!